little drop for a bigger, longer, consistent stream, right?
I need to make sure that I still host.
Nice podcast, guys.
Shut up, woman.
Look, I was mute. Sorry. I apologize. Right. If anyone has any issue with the audio levels, say something. I think they're okay.
Holla at your boy.
Welcome to Spawn Point Podcast 31.
We're now old enough to have a midlife crisis.
Yeah, we're old enough to have a midlife crisis. We had a midlife crisis. We lost a member. Our family is smaller.
Was that the midlife crisis? Is that what that was? Okay.
Yeah, it was a straight up divorce. We were like, we can do better. we were wrong.
Okay. All right then. Sure.
But you know, we back after a week hiatus and a lot of kind of differences, I guess, because Luke was hosting.
Yeah.
But we're back and hopefully stronger than ever. The plan is to have some streams throughout the month as well, other than the podcast. I'm going to be doing No Man's Sky and some other games on the side on my own. Andy may start doing some stuff. Obviously, we'll be hosting Luke whenever we can on his thing, but if we're not hosting him, just go follow him. I mean, like, really.
It's like the podcast with just me, yeah. And these guys eat there sometimes as well.
I would say it's better, but he doesn't put his suit on.
It's true.
I get fancy for certain things, but when it's just for stream, it's just me chilling. I've ordered shirts specifically for the stream.
So it's, well, I guess he does. Yeah, he does have his own shirt. Spawn Point will get his shirt soon, very soon.
Somebody just tweeted at me, announced Pogba. I don't know what that means.
Yeah,
I believe that is a football thing.
Oh my god, Revy!
Why are football people tweeting at you?
I came and wrote something in chat. Yeah,
thank
you. Yes, you did, Revy. Yes, you did, and that's all we expect.
And she got a condom commercial again. Look, Revy.
Yeah,
I'm not saying they're trying to tell you something, but they might be trying.
But they're trying to tell you something.
I feel like
this podcast brought to you by heathens.
Your schlong needs some protection.
Yeah.
Right. So. How was your day, Andy?
I've been at work again, and because of school holidays, it's super stupid busy, and I don't like it, so...
I should go back to education.
Yeah. I'm now announcing Pogba. I just thought I had to follow through with the tweet. I'm sorry.
Okay, wow. Yeah. But Luke, it's the most expensive football transfer ever or something, probably, I think. Maybe. You can't just announce that, like, on a podcast.
I'm now announcing Pogba.
How was your day, been, Luke?
Pokemon.
Yeah, that's pretty much my day too.
Pokemon.
my brother loves it because it gets me out of the house. Like he's always going to do stuff. He's like, hey Kamal, you want to come? I'm like, no. And now he goes, hey Kamal, you want to come? I say no, and then he says Pokemon, and then I proceed to go, aw.
It's like goddamn it, fine.
You're right. So. You know, that's been happening. I has insane lag. Oh. That sucks. Twitch, man. Am I right? But... Alright, we should get into news. We've done enough lollydagging.
I'm gonna drink.
We've been away from a week. So who wants to get started? Not Luke, because he's drinking.
Not Luke.
Don't do it!
Alright, okay, yeah, you do it, Luke, sure, do it.
Speaking of getting things weird, Doctor Strange trailer came out.
Oh my god, we can show trailers.
We can show trailers.
Do you want to show a trailer?
Let's show a trailer for Doctor Strange!
Oh my god.
Luke's links actually mean something now, because guys, if you haven't noticed, Luke just links videos. Luke doesn't read.
Yeah, who reads? Fucking nerds, am I right?
The lower form of communication.
Josh, oh god, forever. Rip Josh.
Yeah, rip Josh.
No, to be in all realness, just in case anyone's wondering, Josh is real busy now. He's started a course, he's doing a bunch of stuff. He felt like he couldn't commit to this anymore, so he's gone. But he will be a guest, probably our most common guest, whenever he can. So he will be around every once in a while. It's just not, he's not like a solid thing. Just to be clear. Anyway. Okay, Doctor Strange, let's do this. 3, 2, 1, trailer.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
You think you know how the world works? What if I told you the reality you know is one of many?
This doesn't make any sense.
Not everything does. Not everything has to. Through the mystic arts, we harness energy and shape reality. We travel great distances in an instant.
How do I get from here to there?
How did you become a doctor?
Study and practice. Years of it.
Maybe what should be just study and practice magic?
There's a strength to him, but is he ready?
Wait, is the trailer over?
No.
Be careful which path you travel down, Strange. Stronger men than you have lost their way. I am death. And pain. You'll die protecting this world.
I can't do this.
There is no other way.
I've spent so many years peering through time. Looking for you.
Oh wait, no, there's the joke.
But what's this, my monitor? It's the Wi-Fi password. We're not savages.
Doctor Strange! Benedict Cumberbatch.
Yeah, he's doing a good job.
We'll have Cumberbund.
Probably okay. Marvel's weirdest movie yet.
Definitely. I'm really liking it, though, because it's opening a whole new side of the universe.
Yeah.
Which will be fun. Also, Rota said earlier that I can't read. I would like to point out that I taught myself to read. So, suck it, Rota. I am a superior human.
Taught yourself to read wrong.
Yep.
Okay, I'm sorry, look.
The proudest moment, Kamal, and took shit on it.
Revy's making miniatures right now. Revy sent me a bunch of pictures of her miniatures.
Yeah, I saw those pictures. They look cool as hell.
They are.
Benedict
Cumberbatch. Opinions on Doctor Strange trailer?
Very good. I don't know much else of the cast other than Benedict Cumberbatch and
Black Man,
the guy who was in Serenity.
I learned how to pronounce this and everything. It's Chihuahua, I think.
Chihuahua Alfer.
It's not that. It's
Chihuahua Alfred.
Yeah, good job.
I did it.
Then it's got the Danish person that Anne didn't shut up about. Mads Mikkelsen, I think it is.
Look, Anne is a proud patriot of her racist white country.
Yep. Everyone knows your country is really good when you fly your national flag on birthday.
I'm kidding, Danes. I'm sure you're...
I wasn't. What?
Anyway.
This is so off topic right now.
I don't know. I like the look of it. You don't see much of the villain. I don't think, anyway. It's hard to tell with that trailer.
It looks like Avengers meets Inception.
I was going to say, I was getting a lot of Inception vibes when they were all like turning buildings around and stuff.
I guess that's just because it's like the only movie that kind of did CG to that immense level.
Yeah.
It
was just like literally reshaping the entire planet.
Mm-hmm. Except they were doing it in dreams and this is with magic, right? Because he's like, I still don't really understand how Doctor Strange works. Does he like bend dimensions and stuff?
Yeah, I think that's how it is. Like, I don't think people see this. As far as I'm aware, like, it's not like, oh, New York's upside down and on me.
No, it's literally magical dimensions. like illusions and stuff, so that could like that sort of stuff could literally just be what's happening in his head that he's not really able to see, because like they can get into each other's minds and stuff and like, you know, try to bend their wills or whatever. But I to be honest, I look at that trailer and I don't even care if the villains be bad. I just want to see a whole new world. Like,
yeah.
It's definitely exploring a side of the Marvel Cinematic Universe that we haven't seen. Like, with Guardians of the Galaxy, we got to see outer space.
It's one of those films that I'm going to go watch regardless. Like you know how Suicide Squad got bad reviews? But I'm not going to go watch that because I didn't care. Well, if Doctor Strange gets bad reviews, I'm still going to go watch it. I need to see how this turns out for myself.
Because it's an interesting enough premise for you to actually want to see it for yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, makes sense.
Exactly. Every time George makes that face after a drink now. I like this game.
I like this game, yeah.
Drink. Good thing we made him do his news first. Drink.
Yeah. You can do your news, then you can become a, like,
dying mess. Alcoholic.
Yeah. Okay, sure. That's all.
But that I think they've timed the Doctor Strange and having Iron Fist like really well, because it's like both of these things are going to be exploring this side of the Marvel Universe.
Oh yeah,
and it'll be nice.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
I forgot Iron Fist was the thing
with all. Yeah, I thought it was just One Punch Man.
George, stop!
Right. So yeah, when does it come out again?
No idea. I know everything but dates. You know this.
Well, I didn't pay attention to the trailer. It was on the trailer, chat. We're professional. You can read.
Doctor Strange just released it as set as November 4th.
We're professional to the point where people are
at least November 4th in the USA. It doesn't have a universal release date. That's right, obvious.
That's close enough, man.
Yeah, it'll be around then.
Yeah, I would imagine it'll be within a few days of that.
I mean, I doubt it'll be in, like, and the US and then nobody else, because people would rage. Speaking about rage, Niantic are getting a bit of it for Pokemon Go.
Oh, is this what we're doing?
Yeah, this is what we're doing. This is why I wanted to go first, because this was coming.
Okay. So this is a good chunk of my news, too.
Yeah, just go from, yeah, to stop, but...
Start us, Luke, and then I will proceed to... Like, Luke will be good cop and I'll be bad cop, unless Niantic and you a new one.
Mm. I mean, I've got nothing good to say about Niantic.
Oh! I'm just used to you being like, dude, this is not the dynamic that I signed on for. I signed on for you being like, companies aren't all that bad, and me being like, no, they're the devil in the cheap economy. This is what I signed on for. Okay, carry on, Luke. I'm not prepared.
So I'm gonna bring up two points. One, I'm gonna go with the less stupid one, I guess, about the whole Twitter thing with Niantic right now, where they're saying that it was a small comment, by the way. This is before the big thing. That apparently they're not able to respond to players on their Twitter because they're too busy.
No. Which is garbage.
Which is garbage. Like, you, like, if you're gonna have a if you're a company and you're gonna have a Twitter, get somebody just.
I mean, it's not even that. It's the fact that you're a games company and you have like a lot of people using your app or your game. You have a duty to respond to them because
that's just how
that works. Especially it's a service.
You're not selling them Tetris. It's not like buy it and it never gets touched again by you guys. You're selling us a continuous service. And you have to have support for that service.
I just thought the like argument for why they haven't been responding to players was just absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. This is we're essentially just like, no, we just don't want to. So we just need
We're too busy to man the Twitter. It's like, just hire someone. Gary the intern to post updates on the Twitter.
You're making millions a day. You're telling me you can't hire a new person to respond to us?
It makes sense that they don't have a fucking PR guy. I'm sorry.
They should have had someone in place in the first place. They shouldn't have to hire someone now, but, you know.
Yes.
On the plus side, it's definitely not a lie, because they clearly don't understand how this works, so they definitely don't have anyone hired in that position.
Yeah, they definitely don't. The next, like, oh damn, we have to respond to our Twitter now. Oh my god, what was this?
I'm really surprised because they. Sorry, just final thing on it. Like, they. Because they had Ingress. Like, they had this other game, and yeah, it wasn't Pokemon Go. It wasn't millions, but it was hundreds of thousands of people. I was like, were you this quiet for 6 years while people played that game and just dealt with your crap? Like, that's really odd to me, but, you know. I guess a smaller audience is a quieter one, so even if they were complaining, nobody was listening to it.
Yeah, I guess.
Ah, well.
So,
Twitter.
The next bigger thing was the fact that in one of the recent updates, for some reason, they got rid of completely the track feature, with every Pokemon is popping up at 3 tracks, and the way it's meant to work, the closer you are to the Pokemon, the less tracks there are. So if it's 1 track, they're really nearby. If it's 2 tracks, you have to do a little bit of walking.
That was...
If it's 3 tracks, it's in your near in your street or whatever.
So this coincided with also the removal of third party tracking sites.
Yes,
they DMCA'd a bunch of third party track, all of the big ones, and. On the back end, they changed a lot of the code to make it pretty much impossible to write one of those sites again and feel like it's usable. You have to search real slow for it to be.
Which was stupid because they're not even offering an alternative.
Yeah, which is, I think that's the biggest argument. Like, lots of people, there's two sides to this. Some people are for the people that are mad about the tracking sites being closed down, and some people are like, that's cheating. That's not how the game's meant to be played. You don't get to be mad about not being allowed to cheat. And then there's the other argument, which is, this was an alternative while you, like, shut them down by all means, but when you fix your crap, like, don't shut it down and leave us blind, you know?
Or partner with one of them. Yeah. Or, like, just be like, okay, we're going to make yours a second part. Like, there's the app, and then there's this app to help you find stuff. Until you fix your own things. And that way, you still make money?
Yeah.
But this way, nobody gets anything, and we're just kind of left to wander in the dark. I saw on my thing the other day that there's an Onyx nearby me. I walked everywhere and I couldn't find this son of a bitch. And you're telling me that, like...
It's not a fun... Like, how I play Pokemon Go right now is literally, I just walk. I walk to where I want to go, which is usually Pokestop to Pokestop. And if something shows up, it shows up. I don't even use the nearby thing anymore. Because it's like... It's pointless. It's like walking around like a headless chicken. It's like, what am I going to freaking find with this thing now? Like, it doesn't give me any information. It's not fun.
You're essentially just going to hope you get lucky at this point.
Yeah.
I stopped and I started wandering around the car park and, like, I almost got in the way of a car. And I was like, you know what? It's not worth it.
Like,
because you've gotten rid of these ways that I can find these things, I've almost got killed. Like,
damn it, Niantic. You almost killed one of our few remaining hosts. What are we meant to do? God damn it.
I'm being Kamal here.
We're back to this. This has batteries in it. I'm taking
Also, do we have any... I don't know anything about this whole legendary thing that's going
okay.
on.
Okay, just to kind of wrap up on the earlier 2 points. On the Niantic side, they did finally, after basically a week and a half of this, because we haven't had a podcast for a while, they finally responded. They said the reason they took down the tracker sites, this is the reason they're putting as their official reason after saying it was cheating, is, and this is real, it's not a lie, whether it is the main reason is a different thing, but they were causing traffic to be at about 8 times what it should be for the player base. Because they search, rampantly, you know? And they were like, this was slowing the rollout. They were saying this was, like, the main reason they couldn't launch in Rio. Like, in Brazil, or South America, actually, the entirety.
Yeah, I read this, yeah.
And they're saying, now that we removed that, we got to launch in South America and we were stable. Okay, so that's one of their points. The other thing was that the three feet tracking is being replaced by something. They haven't told us what exactly or when, but they're working on something. Which is better than no information, but isn't really information. So, you know, you're getting there, Niantic. Just keep talking. Just keep talking, honestly. Just keep talking to us.
Go from unhelpful non-information to helpful information.
Yeah.
And then responding to all the people, and then, boom, you're like actually a nice company that people are going to enjoy working with.
Yeah, because people want to like your game. Like, God damn it, they want to like your game.
You're just making it real hard.
Yeah. So the final thing in Niantic's, like, triple failure in the past few weeks has been that apparently customer service at Niantic was randomly awarding people legendary Pokemon when they complained. So you would, for example, this Ohio woman, which is the one we have the most information for because she was really public about it, because she was happy, but it turned into a mess. She was like, she emailed them, and I think the original email was that she couldn't catch a really good Pidgey that she found. Yes, a Pidgey. And they were like, oh, we're so sorry. You've probably caught a Pidgey by now. Here, have Articuno.
Oh, God.
Because Articuno is just like a really, really good Pidgey, right?
For people who don't know, Articuno is a legendary, and he's also currently not available to catch in the game, no matter what you do. Unless you email them and complain about a Pidgey, apparently. So this couple in Ohio proceeded to show this to the world, and everyone was like, you're hackers. You're hackers. And I was with the rest of the world, because I was like, you know what, Niantic's dumb, but like, this is something else. and that went on for like a week and a half, and they actually did a Twitch stream where they showed it, and they were like, chat, ask us anything, we'll do anything. Like,
they did loads of stuff as well.
Yeah, chat was like, show it on a different phone, they did.
Yeah, they lost different phones, they changed profiles, like, they logged out and in, they like went through all the things, and they were still like, nah, not real, you're still hacking.
Yep, and then Niantic comes out with a statement and says, pretty much, not outright, none of this was outright, it was basically subtext, but you know, like, the way people will interpret these things. They were like, we have removed all of the Pokemons that these trainers got by disingenuous means. So they basically put the blame on the trainers, and they were like, they implied that these guys were hackers. They basically implied, yes, they're hackers. And then these guys got harassed even more than they were already getting harassed, which you can imagine was pretty bad. They emailed Niantic back and they were like, guys, people are calling us liars. Like, this is causing a lot of distress for us. And then finally, after all of that, Niantic put out a Facebook statement which said they did give these Pokemons out by accident. And that was the best we got. And they didn't get, like, the trainer got an apology as well, and they got 10 incense. Yay, 10 incense.
Oh
my God.
Totally worth it.
And it was just this pisses me off on a lot of levels. Firstly, I don't understand how a company that's current biggest and only concern is Pokemon Go, a Pokemon game, cannot understand that you can't just give people legendaries. It doesn't make sense. Like, how little does your understanding of your product have to be to feel like that's an okay idea?
It seems like a really, like a slapdash solution to someone complaining. It was like, oh, we've got like a complaint. That's the first one in the queue. Oh, throw a thing at it. There we go. That's going to wait. It's all fine now.
Yeah. So that was, like, that was my first issue, was it? My second issue was how they were only caring about themselves after, like, it got found out and was a big deal. They were, like, trying to protect themselves, and they didn't care what they did to these people, like, until they had to come to them multiple times going, like, we're actually getting, like, threats on our life, we're actually getting harassed on a regular basis, because you're lying! You're, like, lying about us lying! Like, it's...
Wrong with you.
It's not cool, man. Niantic's really upset me in the past, like, week and a half. It's, like, really,
like, I just need to do better, alright?
It's, like, Niantic recently, like, if anybody wants to write a book, like, anybody who runs, like, a business or economics school somewhere on, like, how to destroy the biggest product in the world ever in a couple weeks, here you go. Here's a case study. it's a pretty good one.
And No Man's Sky.
No Man's Sky is another good case study right now. But yeah, so that's pretty much the Niantic Pokemon play.
If they keep this up, we're going to have people being exactly like Ys Earrings. Speaking of Ys Earrings, there's a bit of beer news.
That's a bit of bad news.
That was a stretch.
Well, I fucking did it, so deal.
That's a bit of bad news.
There's a bit of bad news.
Luke's a bad man.
I know, right? I keep finding bad news. It's great.
It's like you're looking for it. It's like you're actively like bad news.
I'm sure. Luke's just Googling bears and see what happens. Look,
just because bears are bears does not mean that they don't do things every week, Kamal. They have their own lives.
Sure, okay. Today in bad news.
Uh-huh. Today's bad news.
Luke's nature update. Let's guess.
Can we, every time we do the bear news, can there be an image of a Photoshop bear on my face?
We can look into it. Bad news, and I don't know how I feel about that.
We're turning into a local news channel now.
A man had some beers that broke into his house, and super weird. The first video shows the cubs and the mother just like, you know, wandering about the hall, like whatever. And then the second video is a bit more dangerous. I kind of had my... kind of scared me a little, seeing that one.
They're super cute.
They are super cute.
They're just like big teddy bears. How that's scary. It's fine.
Yeah, you heard the word...
Look at a little cutie pie.
You heard the word bear, Revy. Luke has an obsession.
I know.
Bears.
So that's the first video.
That was the first video with the mummy. And then there is a second video of... the mother bear charging the man inside of his own home. And that's kind of scary, because we haven't had that for a really long time. There's actually been a spike in bear populations in North America, and they're just going into more people's houses and not caring anymore.
They're taking over the real estate now.
Oh, God.
Bell lives there now.
Killing peeps and children. It's just...
Yeah.
Well, I try to make it a joke,
if a bear is in your house, don't stand next to it.
Yeah, don't film it. That's kind of probably... But he's dead now, this guy. He's probably dead now.
But yeah,
oh, God, I need to drink because George just noticed a bear. I need to pour myself another drink.
That wasn't really a poke, Jim. Look, George just wants Luke to drink.
Revy says there's a book written by a woman that describes her journey of trying to have sex with an adult grizzly bear. Like, what?
Yep.
It's called Bear. Huh. Simple name. I'm liking the simplicity.
I mean, it does what it says on the tin, I guess. Just still about that bear.
Have you read this book, Revy?
I can imagine it's an interesting, if somewhat disturbing, read.
Is it true?
Is his name Tormund?
Because I could see it being real, but at the same time, give me it being fanfic.
So,
come on.
Followed by the queerest pair of cubs with no pelt.
Sorry. But yeah, that was the bear news for this week. I'm going to drink now because Poke Champ.
Okay, ending the bear news of the week, let's cue the next little co-o.
George is wasted, y'all. George is wasted. Oh, I can believe it.
Apparently, Revy says it is true.
I believe it. Weird.
That's disturbing, but I do believe it.
It's only a matter of time before the war with the bear begins. Andy, do you want to talk about robot war stuff?
Okay.
Which war are you?
Luke has decided.
Oh, that's just sure. Okay. Alright, so, my first news is going to be about. I know it started a couple of weeks ago, but obviously we weren't here last week. But
I was drinking.
The much new, because Luke was drinking and Kamal was on a plane. But the much hyped return of Robot Wars has happened.
I've seen an episode!
I know.
I've seen it's an episode! Robot Wars, Pub Champ.
Yep, there we go. Robot Wars, yep, you gotta drink, Luke. That's definitely worth it.
Wait, what?
gotta drink.
Gotta drink it.
But yeah, Robot Wars started a couple of weeks ago, and. Oh my god, it was just as good as I remember it. It was amazing.
Dude, it's better.
I mean, no, it's not better because Craig Charles isn't the host anymore.
Was Dario O'Brien always a host?
No, Dario O'Brien's the new host.
But he's so tall.
Okay. So, regardless.
That's why I argue for it being better.
Regardless of his height, he still wasn't the original host.
The robots look tiny. He's like, oh, I'm a giant, little giant comedian, man.
To be fair though, Craig Charles is currently in the middle of filming a new season of Red Dwarf, so I don't want him being trapped by that.
Oh my god, there's a new season of Red.
I feel like Craig Charles has got the talent to do both of those things at the same time.
He's bringing all the originals back, man.
He is, man. I love Red Dwarf as well.
Nice.
But yeah, there was. So you watched the first episode, right? Come on, the one with.
No, I watched the second episode.
Oh, the second. Okay, so.
I meant to catch up on my first episode, but I still haven't got around to it. I loved it.
It's been pretty interesting because they've brought in some of the old robots, like some of the ones I remembered from the original series.
For people who aren't from England, Robot Wars is a show where they get contestants to build like giant robots. These things weigh about like 100 to 200 kilograms ish.
Generally.
And then they fight. That's it. Like, and then they pick a winner. You just gotta watch giant machines fight. So
there you go, Rhoda. Just for you. But yeah, essentially it's been yeah, I know.
Andy's naked, I don't like it.
Okay, I'm putting the bag on, it's fine to see what I'm doing.
But yeah, so that's just a little summary of what Robot Wars is.
Yeah, so they brought in some of the old robots.
It's super American now that I think about it. Like, I'm surprised this is a British show. Like, it's a super American concept. Let's make big robots and fight!
Yeah, I guess.
But hey, it works.
Yeah, I mean, it brought everyone back. Like, it's been getting really high views and everyone's been very positive, but I don't think I've heard many,
Yeah.
But there was a little bit of an, thing where one of the robot things got a lot of tweets going against it because they were just like, I think they did one of the most really boring fights in the second one.
Oh.
And then they said, Foxic, I think it was.
Yeah, freaking screw that guy. Screw that Foxic guy. This contender is old. It's so much talk. That's my issue with him. I don't know. Have you seen the second episode? He keeps going like, oh, next round, I'm going to smash it. We're going to fix everything. And then his robot goes into it and just sits there in the corner.
It was terrible. He's like, oh, we're an indestructible robot. Then we have no weaknesses. And then the commentator was just like, this is genuinely the worst episode of robot. The worst fight I've ever seen between two robots in all of the time. And he commented on every single episode.
Yeah.
So I think that was the only piece of negative thing, and it was because just one guy who was just being a boss.
Stop it, Luke. That's a terrible robot. That's not how it works.
I'm trying.
You would not stand a chance against like one of the robots in the arena.
Yeah, I would.
But yeah, I'm gonna keep watching it all because it looks awesome. And then achieve your dreams of drinking. Yep.
I'm calling Ronald to put a stop to the dancing. Do it.
He's going insane. Anyway,
yeah, that's true. Lawrence is losing it.
In summary, Robot Wars is awesome. Truth. If you haven't seen it, go watch it.
Truth.
And then I'm gonna go talk about another thing.
Good. That's what we do here. We talk about things.
Yeah, so there's a thing you guys won't know anything about. There's a new expansion coming out for Binding of Isaac.
Hey, don't you question... I know I have... Oh, I didn't even know
that. Shut up, come on. No, you don't. Shut up.
You know of
Binding of Isaac. For people who don't, it's a bit of a roguelike shooter where it's very weird. It's all sorts of... strange.
Is the artist linked to Meat Boy? Is that correct?
It's the same guy. It's Adam McMillan, the guy who made Meat Boy.
Yes.
It's the same guy who does this.
If you want to see more about that guy, you can watch the indie game movie. Great movie.
Yep.
You should watch it.
Awesome movie.
It's really interesting. Anyway. Yeah,
it's adding a new characters. It's adding new items, and apparently it's doing a thing that lets... Because one of the main things that people didn't like about the game was the fact it's too random. Like sometimes it was... Sometimes it makes it so you can just get absolutely destroyed by like getting a couple of bad pickups in like the first couple of rooms.
Yeah.
And then that just means, hold on, I'll just permit.
It's interesting to get like a balance tweak this like late into the game.
Yeah,
like,
it's just...
Like, people
I think
are kind
it's,
of used to it now, surely, right?
It's not really a balance thing to balance the items. It's more of there's a few new items being introduced that can...
Ah, they're like essentially, around the hour, they kind of fill in the gaps.
Essentially what it does... is it allows you to what was it say? It's one of the characters that lets you burn items like out of your own like inventory for stat boosts.
Uh-huh.
So, like, you get rid of the... If you've got, like, rubbish active items or stuff like that, you can burn them and you'll get a permanent stat boost.
So, like, he can become, like, real buff on his own. Like, without any items. Like, he's, like... That's cool.
Essentially, yeah. And that there's stuff, like, there's things called trinkets you can get that give you various little passive effects and stuff.
Oh, you can post the link, Revy. I don't think, like, we have even a moderated link system here. Like,
I think you're good.
I'm pretty sure you
Well, Anne just posted the one before, so I think you're okay.
But Anne is a mod.
Yeah, I know, I just realised that as I said, it's shut off.
Come on, guys, you got to post Poke Jam. How this works. Oh, my, it's in the rules, fuck!
Yeah, I'm probably going to be playing it again.
Oh my god, all I have to do is to die is to freaking feed Luke his death. Okay, I got this. Hit me! Hit me, Gator! Hit me!
Oh, it's just the Wikipedian thing about the bear thing.
Oh, sweet. Cool. You know what? We'll add that to link dump.
I'll put it in the link dump. The story tells of a lonely librarian in Northern Ontario who enters a sexual relationship with a bear. Well,
and I think that tells you all you need to know, little human cubs.
Just tell me when I go to drink.
Oh, I died. Oh, no. I died. That took ages.
But yeah, essentially, I'm going to play, like, I haven't played it for a while, but I'm probably going to play again.
Okay, I'll play properly because I don't want to kill George. And I'm bad enough as it is.
Anyway, that's probably all I have.
Is a game I should try. I was just saying I should try Binding of Isaac. I hear about it so often, and just like I haven't really played it.
It's super cheap. I think it's like I've got it on Xbox and on PC now.
Oh wait, question. Uh-huh. Is this a update to the new one or to the old one?
This is the rebirth. This is the. I don't think they're updating the old Binding of Isaac anymore.
Yeah, I didn't. I mean, it makes sense. I was just wondering. Indie devs do weird stuff sometimes. Sometimes they're like, "Hey, we're gonna update everything."
I think the original's like the new one's like £12. I think at least last time I checked, it might have gone down in price now because it's been out for a while.
Mm-hmm.
But they haven't announced whether this is an unpaid DLC or whether it's just a free update. Cause so far they've done one, which was just a free update that was a patch, and one that was a paid expansion.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure which one's which, but. I'm sure we'll find out more at some point.
Yay, finding out more at some point.
Yeah. And another thing that got released last week that we can talk about now.
What is this, Andy?
It's the early access version of We Happy Few launched last week.
We Happy... Oh.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I played the early access bit, like the little... Because you get, like, three quarters of an hour of free...
Quickly... We Happy Few is it was Kickstarter game survival horror, right?
Yeah, I was getting yeah. Right. So basically, it's a bit like it's kind of sort of Bioshock-esque, kind of more of a. People were expecting it to be like a linear Bioshock style game where it's in like a very dystopian style future.
I think one of its big selling points was meant to be that every time you start it, like it's kind of like a roguelike in the sense that every time it, like the world kind of reshapes.
Yeah, and it's all. Procedurally generated as you continue through the game.
Yeah.
Alright. But, so I played some of the early access version for a bit, and...
And Andy loved it, and it was great, and everyone was happy, and all expectations were met.
Or... So a lot of people were surprised about how survival-esque it was. So it's much more open world than you would expect.
Yeah.
It's, so... A lot of it was based on inventory management, which I was not really a fan of. Like, I don't mind inventory management and stuff, but there's just so many little things that you need to do and fiddle about with. So like, everything, like, you can pick up little mini quests as you go around the game, and each of them requires you to build certain things, and that requires you to get, let's say, leather or sticks or rocks or whatever.
Yeah.
And you don't really have a huge amount of... inventory space, so you have to be like juggling all of that for ages.
I did hear it felt like work.
Yeah, it was. It
Which
was
is
a
not
very.
What you want your game to feel like.
Yeah, it was almost. It was a chore for a while.
Because unfortunately, most people have real jobs. And
yeah.
Oh, is Rota heading out? See you, Rota.
Yeah, yes. Bye.
You're probably we won't be live, but maybe Luke will be live or something.
In 3 hours, Luke will probably be live. Yeah,
I will try.
I won't be. But yeah, anyway, it's also the quests were very muddled and stuff. It seemed like you could... I had about 12 quests active at one point, and I didn't really know which one I was supposed to be progressing with at all. So it was all very sort of... I think it tried too much to be very open. Mm-hmm. So it didn't really have much of a cohesive... This might have been just because I had it was a very quick look. You only got three quarters of an hour
to
of play through.
What you're saying is what I heard a lot of people who did in-depth reviews say.
Yeah.
The only people I've honestly seen be positive about it was YouTubers who played about 30 minutes.
Hmm.
And I was really disappointed because I was looking forward to this. But it looks like they went more the survival route and less the horror route, and people were expecting more the horror route and less the survival route.
Yeah, it's kind of got... It had some good points. That its design looks very interesting. It's got good graphics and stuff, and it has a lot of... It's got some nice quirky humor, and everyone's very British.
The world is still interesting.
I like the world. I like the characters. It's you can knock people out and you can hear your character just oh, please just go to sleep, or don't want to be a bother, and so I like that. It's very stiff of a little British humor, which I like. Yeah. But what a good part of it seems to be the game's developers seem to be taking all this in, so they're responding to people who who are giving them complaints and stuff. So
it looks like they may be the first people to use
to actually learn from an experience. Yeah.
Wait, listening to their fan base?
What is I know, this? Right? Who does that? Apparently, the guys who make We Happy Few, because they've heard it.
Yeah,
they said they're going to try and streamline the inventory system and try to make things feel a bit more...
I'm actually kind of excited for you to have, having tried this, to try the final game, when it comes out, and see, how different it is.
Mm-hmm. I'll probably do it and then see whether it works or not.
They did it, or they didn't, and they lied to us.
But yeah, hopefully they'll fix it, because I still think it has a lot of potential. I do like the idea of the game, and I do like the storyline that goes down, but...
Yeah, for sure.
It just needs... To be fair, if they tweak the inventory system and make the map a bit more accessible, that'll solve a lot of the problems.
Yeah.
So it's not as if it's, totally unsavable. I'm pretty sure they could make it okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, yeah,
they have some of the harder stuff down, the procedural generation, as far as I'm aware, does work. And the world looks interesting, and the graphics are beautiful, so, that's difficult stuff. So it's not
that's the hard stuff.
They've only done the easy stuff.
Yeah, they just need to maybe make items a bit more abundant as well, because I know I was watching a Jim Sterling video, that's the one that I've got on the link dump.
Do we know what engine they used to... I'm going to go check.
You check it out. So Jim Sterling was doing a video on it, and he said he literally got stuck at a point where, because of the procedural generation, he couldn't progress with a certain quest because he needed a certain amount of fabric, I think, to make a suit for something.
Oh.
And there was at least in the part that was early access, there was only so many places that could generate items.
Yeah.
And he couldn't find enough of the certain item to make it.
It does feel like a bit more of an early access issue.
But yeah, I feel like once they've expanded, you get the expanded game, that shouldn't be an issue.
Okay, it's made on Unreal Engine 4 too, so that's pretty flexible. It should be okay to make some larger changes to how the gameplay works.
Yeah. I don't think it doesn't come out.
I was
out
worried
all.
That they made their own engine, in which case it would have been really specific, and then it would have been very hard for them to change a lot of stuff.
Yeah. But yeah, it's coming out at some point this week, this year, so hopefully it'll be fixed by then. Sorry.
I'm looking at the podcast drinking game. George just sent it to me.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, drink whenever there is a PogChamp moment. Number two, drink when Luke doesn't pronounce the T in a word. Drink whenever they show a trailer.
Okay.
Drink whenever Kamal dies in Mythical Graveyard Uprising.
Okay, I'm like.
Drink every time you see Luke pour a drink. Drink whenever Luke dances.
Wait, that
Luke
would be
dances.
Endless. Okay, guys. Okay,
I think they mean a sip, not
So this is just drink forever, right?
Luke doesn't have to drink according to... This is just for them.
Yeah.
So, what are the rules for Luke?
Drink whenever Luke dances.
Drink whenever he pours a drink, because then he'd just be pouring drinks forever.
Down the drink if Andy removes his glasses.
Oh, well, okay.
Twinsies drink double. I don't know what that means.
You guys are idiots for sending us this, because this gives us more power.
Yeah, we're just going to manipulate it and make you... What if I just leave my glasses off? Do you just have to drink,
Every time Luke is obviously not following the conversation.
Oh, well, that's a lot of drinking right there.
Oh, snap!
I can't like help one. It if I haven't got an opinion on something.
I like that one.
Oh...
You get
every time Kamal levels up in a game.
Okay. That's nice.
Shots.
That's nice.
Do a shot. Do a shot every time Seam drops for everyone not dressed. You do a shot when someone new follows.
Ah.
Like I said, Josh, you shouldn't.
George,
you shouldn't have shown us the thing. Then I'm just
I think it was George and Anne, because they're both sitting in Discord.
Ah, GG guys. I'm liking it, honestly. Like, it's a very, very thorough... Like, you've captured many of the, like, essences of this podcast. Like, we can all pay attention.
Is that, and I couldn't see what you just wrote there.
You're gonna get it.
George just said to me, Anne, help me with this. Don't blame this all on me.
Okay. Anne will get some of the credit from me and some of the blame from Luke. Right.
Anyway. Another thing.
Another one.
I was just browsing on Rock Paper Shotgun a couple of days ago, just when I was looking for extra stuff, and I found out that apparently Disney are releasing some of their old classic games again.
Do you need to adjust your glasses, Andy? Just a little bit.
I do.
just take them off and put them back on again.
Fuck, I have to...
Cool.
Wait, what happened to Down a Drink? Down a Drink is gone.
I think they got rid of it because I took my glasses off about 6 times in a row. So, yeah, anyway. GOG has brought back a bunch of really old like Disney games. Like, I don't know about you, but when I was little, I played a lot of them. The Lion King NES game. It was on PC as well. It was like a super. It was like an old 16-bit version, and it looks super awesome. So, I'm pretty happy they're bringing that back again, because I remember it being super difficult, and I don't know. It was just fun. It's just nostalgia. I feel like it's just them cashing in with this whole the little mini NES we talked about last time.
Yeah.
But yeah, it looks really cool, and I like it. But yeah, that was just a little object of interest I wanted to bring up before I go back to Pokemon again. Because, you know...
We're back to Pokemon?
Yeah, so... No, my first one is about Pokemon Go, but it's not directly about the game. I think we have talked about this before, but it was about the streamer who was playing Pokemon Go in the park. Mm-hmm. Can you guess where I'm going there?
Yes, I can. What happens when you stream and you do it in public and people know where you are?
Well, what they did was...
There's a few bad things that can happen in that situation, actually, I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Alright, carry on. Sorry.
Yeah, they got him swatted in the park.
Yeah.
So apparently they called the local police and said he had a gun or something, I think.
Uh-huh.
But then, luckily, the cops turned up and he just explained, like, look, I'm just doing this sort of stuff, and showed him all the gear and stuff, and it was fine.
Mm-hmm.
But again, it's just...
I watched the video for that, and it was very funny, because he was like, he knew it was happening before it happened, because announced it. And he just kind of sat down, and he was, like, ready for it to happen. So he was trying, like, he was calmed himself down, wanted to make sure, obviously, like, he wasn't gonna, like, be shocked or resistant, because that doesn't end well with cops. And he was like, they're not going to take a gun out on me, chat. Like, because chat was like, be careful, they might shoot you. And then the guy shows up and he's holding a gun out already. And he's like, okay, maybe they'll take a gun out on me. Like, and that was like kind of the last thing he said to the stream. And I was like, god damn, I hope that guy's okay. Mm. But yeah, he was fine.
Yeah, he was fine. I think he posted afterwards on Twitter that, I think he posted, I'm fine, but obviously my stream's done now for a bit. I'm just going to go and... lie down and lament about how people are horrible.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just shows like people are still bots, regardless of whether they're people. I don't know, Pokemon. We always talk about Pokemon being good, but people still want to ruin it, I guess.
Yeah.
But fine.
Just an FYI to the chat. I followed that entire conversation. I just had nothing to add to it.
Maybe you should, like, as a podcast host, have more to add to things.
As a host?
Yeah. You know, because, like, we all add opinions and stuff.
Maybe. I don't know. That's just a suggestion.
Yeah, and anyway, I have one more thing about Pokemon, and it's not even about Pokemon Go.
Yes.
It's about the trailer they released for Pokemon Sun. Oh, it's a trailer as well, so yeah, we didn't put that up. Yeah, Pokemon Sun and Moon, the new trailer for that.
Okay, I got this.
So it releases a few new extra Pokemon and evolutions and some
and it begins.
Things. So I'll just shut up while we play that.
Execute.
Three, two, one, play trailer. Oh my god, this is long.
It's a few minutes. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. No, that's a bit ridiculous.
So. They're adding this new Alola forms. So Pokemons that already had old like evolutions or old characteristics are getting kind of redone. This is an excuse to not make new Pokemon. and it's pretty sweet. It's totally not anything else.
Dragonite confirmed, also, in the game.
Oh, that's sweet.
Hmm.
It looks like an interesting aspect of this Alola forms is that they seem to be moving towards ice. Like, more ice Pokemon, more ice types. I don't know if they felt like ice type was being under, kind of...
There's not as many ice types, is there?
I don't know. There are quite a few added in Gen 2. Well, fair enough. Maybe they're just rediscovering ice. They're like, oh my god, ice is pretty cool. They've also added this new thing called stances, or styles. And like this one Pokemon specifically here can change its stance using an ability, and it will change its Pokemon's like actual attributes, so it can become like psychic or fairy or fire or whatever.
Fire, isn't it?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, psychic, fire, electric, ghost. Yeah, just from a stance change, which is pretty. Interesting.
Cool.
Definitely, like at the higher end, like when you're actually skill is actually involved in these battles, will be an interesting thing to have.
Yeah. The thing I don't get about the whole form change thing is like why it's ice. Like they're on like a really hot island, and then everything form changes to ice.
Yeah,
I think it's going to be like the common Pokemon thing, where like one of the islands is going to be like an ice island, or an area on the island will be like an icy part. And it'll be like, what, how? And it's just like, shut up, this is Pokemon. Yeah. It's like, in the world of Pokemon, all the biomes can apparently exist, like, side by side together. No issues.
Oh,
at all.
Is this Sun and Moon, George?
Yeah.
The new one's coming out this year.
Yeah. November 28th, I think.
Already looking at the moon.
Oh my god, that Pokemon is just like a cute little bear.
Gumshoes.
Bear?
Oh, yeah, the bear, that's... yeah.
Oh, and that Pokemon turns from a little girl into, like, a woman.
Pretty much. So, there's the Donald Trump Pokemon, is what everyone's talking about. I'm not sure if that's intentional or not. The weasel thing looks so, like, much like Donald Trump, but I'm not sure if it's an accident or not.
Look, a donkey turns into a horse.
I like that donkey, to be fair. That's one of the new Pokemon I like.
That's the one you like.
Yeah, it looks cool. I like it. Shut up, Kamal. You like the stupid old man dragon.
Yeah, we have very different.
Old man dragon's great.
Thank you, Luke.
Fucking all you dragons are wildly energetic.
Because he agrees with me.
No, old man dragon's great because it just goes to show that all the dragons don't have to be these, like, you know,
yeah, super rich,
massive, powerful beasts. There's just this one that's just
don't
like, oh, go away,
I've
not lived too long. Oh, yeah, don't bother.
It's cute. Oh my god, Adam agrees with you. Now you know you're wrong.
No. Oh. Okay.
Oh my god, I just saw the bit in the island that has ice on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know that said this. These island trials, they said.
Yeah.
So I guess maybe that'll tie in all the forms and stuff.
There's a volcano.
As I almost die.
Auras are a thing. Honestly, they seem to be doing a lot with the base mechanics in this game. I mean, good, but also I don't know why. We're good. I'm not always wrong, okay? I mean, look, it's just a statistic.
Just most of the time.
Yeah, it's just like...
They took Digivolving.
Yeah.
Now they're taking Hacky. I don't like it.
That what the Mega Revolutions were, is that Digivolving?
Oh, to be fair, there's, like, Power and Z-Power and stuff like that. I guess that is what they're doing. They're bringing a lot more of the... This is a card game thing. This was in the Pokemon card game for a while. So I guess that's what they're doing. They're bringing more of, like, the card game elements into the game.
Yeah. So like, they're trying to, like, merge them all together, maybe?
Giga Volt Havoc!
Yeah, it's like a Z move. Like, these are, like, special moves you just want to battle, which is... interesting.
Yeah, and the trainer has to do, like, a dance.
I wonder how much gigawatts it is, and whether it'll be able to power my glory.
Oh my god, that was a nuclear bomb. One of them is...
I was looking at this, I was watching this trailer, these are totally overkill at this point, right? Like, you're just doing, like, a nuclear explosion on, like, a small...
No, but the thing is, Andy, your Pokemon's just fainting, okay? So that's fine.
Are you sure?
And the thing is, will these be in trainer battles?
Yeah, you just go... Ooh, in a trainer battle, and then
there'll just be some guy who's only played like red or silver or whatever, just playing it.
Like,
my Pokemon just mega evolved. It's like, wait, what? Mega use a Havoc Gigawatt electric attack. It's like, what's going on?
Trainer dance hyper. Okay.
Can we talk about Mega Exeggutor then?
So, Pokemon, they were like, Executor. Not getting enough love. You know what is the
issue? I liked Executor, right? No problem with Executor.
Executor is short.
Yeah, that's what it was.
So now he's tall.
He's now 90% neck, and that's how everyone should aspire to, right?
Oh, Luke had an amazing link that compared him to some stuff that was, like, very relevant.
Oh, yeah, that was great. Yeah, that was good.
I don't know if you can find it, post it in chat. If you can,
I'll say
Luke.
On it. Scroll.
All right.
That's all my news, so...
Found it.
What about you, Kamal?
I will now wrap up the podcast with my news.
You make it sound like it's the end soon.
No Man's Sky, a game that will be probably the first of our new single-player games, if it ever comes out, was experiencing some trouble with a company claiming that they stole a formula that they had patented, and we talked about that 2 weeks ago. The week after, since we didn't have a podcast to talk about this is pretty old news, actually, at this point, it was pretty much...
And it's my fault.
Basically, it was pretty much confirmed that they did not use this formula. Or at least they have come to some form of agreement that they're not talking about publicly. And in that agreement was the right for No Man's Sky to represent themselves in a way that they didn't use the formula. Which might sound like a stretch, but it's something that happens a lot in business. That they'd be like, oh, we'll pay you, but you have to let us pretend that we didn't do anything wrong. You know? To keep our brand image. And they're like, yeah, I want you to keep your brand image because I want money off the sales, you know? So that could have happened. We don't really know. But point being, No Man's Sky is still releasing on time. Oh, but wait, it's not releasing on time. It's getting delayed on PC to the 12th. So...
Huzzah!
First single player stream is on the 12th, if anyone's wondering. on PS4, it's still releasing on the 9th. No Man's Sky! Will it be good? Will it be bad? Only time will tell. Right.
Yeah. So, do you think that they just ended up having to pay off this guy with the Super Formula, or...?
I think Sony may have stepped in and shut the company up.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
I think that might have been what happened. Because it's he tweeted like, oh, we have never used the Super Formula thing, and me and the head guy from the company are gonna have coffee after our game launches, as if to like be like, yeah, you're not affecting our launch. And I was like, No Man's Sky, you don't have a big enough dick to talk like that, but Sony has a big enough dick. So I feel like Sony may have got involved, but I'm not sure. I am really excited for No Man's Sky, honestly, and I'm just kind of pissed off that they delayed it on PC, because I was excited for everyone to kind of be like, oh, this this new universe, like, born into existence, and everyone just be, like, raw, like, and experience it all together at the same time. But now we're going to have, like, this period of time where, like, everyone's talking about the PS4 one, and then when it comes out on PC and I'm getting my first impressions, I'll probably be spoiled quite a bit. That's why I'm just a bit disappointed, but, like, I am really excited for the game still. And really intrigued to see how it comes out, regardless of if it's good or bad. I'm kind of just interested to see how it comes out, you know? And yeah, like I said, it'll be our first solo stream, so I'm kind of excited for that too. And the next... I'm not doing this. Because I... Okay, you know what? I was going to talk about the new Quake, because the new Quake got a gameplay trailer. It's boring. You can go watch it.
I'll put it in the link down, but yeah.
It looks boring, guys. I don't know. Are you guys excited? Have you guys felt like you needed an FPS that is a pure FPS but also has abilities but is a pure FPS? I don't know what...
Yes.
Like, that, it makes
what's
no
a,
sense
what's a pure,
to
me. What's a pure FPS as opposed to a not pure FPS?
It makes no sense. I think the selling point behind Quake... I know what the selling point behind the old Quake was like, it's skill! Yeah, just skill, right? And I think what they're trying to do is this one is they're saying, like, it's going to be PC only, high frame rate, like, high fidelity, like, really tight hitboxes, you know? Like, super, like skill-focused experience. But they're also adding in, like, the ability stuff that people liked. So I don't know how that layer is going to affect Quake, because that's not a Quake thing to do, you know?
I've got nothing. I don't know.
We talked about Josh, like, 3 times, Aaron. You know, I'll explain to you again later.
George said he would buy Quake simply for nostalgia.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of people will do that. I hope it's good, for their sake. I mean, a good sign for the Quake community is that it is a PC exclusive and it is being very performance focused, so there's that.
Yeah, I guess the fact that if they were going to try and put it on the consoles and that would just...
Yeah.
Down would just do bad things for it, I guess, like make it downgrade it for... to make it match on both, so I guess the hardcore Quake fans, I guess, will be happy about that.
I assume so, as someone who's never really played Quake.
Yeah, same. So I demand you shut up, and so how about that?
I have nothing to say. And my final piece of news!
Before you say your final piece of news, can I just say George tricked me?
How did George trick you?
He sent me a Snapchat. And then he sent me another one saying that I wasn't replying to him on Snapchat, so I replied to him on Snapchat, and he said, "Ha, you're not paying attention to the conversation, drink scrub."
Ha! Don't know,
George, you don't need to go through all that trouble to make Luke not pay attention to the conversation.
Oh my god!
Yeah, you don't need to try. He'll just do it of his own accord, it's fine.
Okay, my final piece of news is about the Nintendo NX, which is... for anyone who doesn't know, the code name for Nintendo's next console, which is releasing March, but is apparently, they moved up the announcement. It was going to be announced and released in March, which was like a really bad idea, but now they're apparently going to be announcing it in sometime in September and releasing it in March, which is a better idea, but still not the best idea. Best idea would have been to announce it in E3, Nintendo.
Yeah,
you know, because it helps when you build hype for your new thing and let people know about it, rather than just say, oh, we've got a new thing that's right here.
Nintendo don't care no more.
Okay, look, I will give Nintendo one thing, and this is part of this conversation actually right now, because basically we're going to talk about 3 things. We're going to talk about what the NX is probably going to be from a bunch of really high-quality rumors from Eurogamer that are apparently well-sourced, and the hardware specs of this potential console, and pricing, right? But before we start that, Nintendo is... I admire and also, like... Like, I admire this quality of Nintendo, although it is very dangerous quality to have in a business, and it's... I do what I believe I should be doing, not what the market's telling me to do, right? And...
It's a very high-risk strategy, right?
Yeah, it's super high-risk, but... Because it's easy to be Microsoft or Sony and to be like, people want FPS, I'm going to make it FPS. People want graphics, I'm going to do graphics. But Nintendo's stance has always been, I want to bring something new to the table...
The innovators, as opposed to the ones that just try to pander to whoever.
Whether that's like the Wii, and it sold really great, and it was really interesting, and while motion controls didn't hold, they were fun. And, like, that period of time was interesting. Yeah. Or the Wii U, where it was, like, completely pointless and nobody liked it, nobody bought it.
Or they bought it, then traded it in, like, 6 months later, like my brother did.
Sorry. I don't like the new chat.
It's all about making Luke drink, and that's about it.
Yeah.
So, to start with the most Nintendo thing about Nintendo's new console, its gimmick. Have you guys read this, or if you haven't? Okay.
I've read it.
Explain it to me as if you were explaining it to a child hearing this first time.
Nintendo's best-selling thing right now, and the thing they dominate at, is handheld gaming. Because smartphone gaming is kind of a pay-to-win joke right now, and no other company is competing in real handheld gaming, because Sony, like, killed their own console. So the 3DS...
Die, beast!
So the 3DS is killing it, right? So Nintendo's next console is actually going to be a 3DS and a Wii U replacement at the same time. It's going to be a handheld, but also a home console. So the idea is, I've got a tablet here, because this is kind of representative, right? The idea is you're going to have this big, like, controller console, kind of like the Wii U's current gamepad, and it's going to have, like, controls on the side, and a screen in the center, and you can just play it, right? With just this. So I can play video games on just the handheld, like a 3DS, right? And then when I come home, I go to my dock, to my Nintendo NX dock, and I click this into it, and it probably charges as well, but, like, it connects to the TV and gives you, like, a full console experience, right? And then when you're done playing with your friends, like, playing Zelda with your friends, or, like, actually, like, say you're playing Mario Kart with your friends, and then you want to go out and you want to take Zelda with you, you just unplug it from the dock and you go. And it's one system. The point is, like, it's this one uniform experience.
The
selling thing is going to be, like, take your games everywhere. That's going to be that. Cool. Right. Correct. Interesting idea.
Yeah.
Issues.
My thought would be, like, it seems like they're trying to, like, straddle between home console and handheld, and by trying to split it between the two, they're going to be a not very good version of both.
That's the worry, isn't it? That's the difficulty.
Yeah.
And I think where that represents, like, where that kind of rears its head the most is Nintendo's, and always has been Nintendo's weakest point, and that's hardware, right?
Yeah.
To make this thing a handheld that is good, it needs to be light, and it needs to be battery efficient. And to make it a console that is good, it needs to be heavy, and it needs to be power hungry.
Yeah.
Yeah, it needs to have, like, processors and all that, and all the best, like, good, like, hardware, and that's...
Those two things don't...
They're pulling in different directions, aren't they?
Yeah, so, like, they're gonna have to pick, a middle ground that's, like...
Seems like some weird party device. Like, you know a mate who's got one, so it's just like, come over and we'll play some games.
Yeah.
Mm.
How are they gonna sell that? It's like, if you are a child of divorce, you will love this console. Because
look,
you go into each house. My God, I did that anyway with Xbox 360.
For me,
I mean, yeah, that's the whole
it really
thing.
Depends, like, on the form factor. Because, like, honestly, if it was, like, say it was a 3DS, right?
Mm-hmm.
Say it was a 3DS, like, it was as big as a 3DS, and it ran games as well as the Wii U did. And I could plug it into a screen and play Zelda Wii U as well as a Wii U, and then take that would be good. I would love that. I don't know about anyone else, but, like, I would love that experience. Like,
yeah, for sure. It makes a lot of sense if it works perfectly.
Like, imagine Leeds. Like, I'm just taking this thing and I'm just playing on the train, and then when we get there, we play Mario Party off it, because it's also just, like, an everyone console, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's. So, like, just to actually get into, like, how the hardware for this is gonna work, I'm gonna link this. It's not in the link dump, so you wouldn't mind adding it handy.
Yeah, I'll add it to the,
This may not make sense, but I'm drinking because of chins. Carry on.
Because of chins.
I'm now getting personal messages about reasons why I should drink.
Okay. So there's a product called the NVIDIA Shield. Nvidia, for anyone that doesn't know, is a graphics card company. And they make this thing called the Shield. And it's a tablet that has a chip made by them, right? The chip's called the K1. And yeah. it's a fairly high performance chip. It's actually more powerful. It's a tablet, and it has a chip that's actually more powerful than the Xbox 360 and the PS4. I mean, the PS3, not the PS4.
That's cool.
So it's kind of, it's in this place where it's between, like, the two generations we're currently at. Rumor has it they're working on the K2, next generation chip, and it'll be more powerful than that. So that would put it kind of in line with the Wii U and maybe, if you're optimistic, the Xbox One. In a handheld chip, which is, like, really impressive, you know? On the other hand, Microsoft and Sony are both making more powerful consoles, so, like, it'll still be behind, but that's not what Nintendo needs.
Yeah, that's not what they're not bothered about that, right?
They're all about making, like, good gameplay.
I think it just needs to be more powerful than the Wii U. You know, like, I don't want to be, because I am their target consumer. Like, I will be buying this console, you know?
Yeah.
And I will feel really crappy going out and paying for a new console that is weaker, like, performance-wise than their old console.
It's not a nice feeling, is it? Yeah. It makes it feel like you're downgrading.
Yeah, exactly. So that's interesting. So that's potentially the processor they're using. This is a bit more salty of a rumor. So, like, just kind of, like, take that with a grain or two, or, like, a table of salt.
An entire table of salt?
And then the most, like, rumory of all of these rumors. And
the rumoriest of the rumors.
I tell you these, by the way, because I have 100% faith in them, even, like, regardless of how quality the sources are, because I see this as how Nintendo's going to be going.
It seems like a Nintendo move.
Yeah, is the price. And this is where Nintendo may win. Apparently, so earlier this week, one of the big, I think the Wall Street Journal, came out and they said they have sources that are saying that Nintendo's product is going to be so much cheaper than anyone has been expecting it to be, like the new one. And now we've got retailers in the UK saying that they have been told to expect it to be from £150 to £200 on launch.
That is absurdly cheap for a console.
For a launch price console? Yeah.
It's absurd, yeah.
Like, people probably don't remember this, but when the PS4 and the Xbox launched, we were talking £400, £450. Like,
I think I paid £350 for my Xbox One when that came out.
I paid £500.
Yeah, because it was like Kinect linked and everything to Xbox, wasn't it?
To get on the fucking on release when there was nothing.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, hey, Cam, what do you want to play? I guess we're stuck with Dead Rising 3, right? It's like, it's like the game's so rubbish.
Loyal,
the game's so rubbish, yeah?
Yeah.
That you have to make your own fun. You have to force yourself to enjoy the game. Because it would have just been crap.
But look, it was next gen.
Okay, I was impressed for 5 minutes about the amount of zombies, and then I was like, oh my god, but there's it's literally Dead Rising 2, isn't it?
But to be fair, George, I got a PS4, so it wasn't really because I was waiting for Kinect to be removed, it was because I bought a different console.
Yeah, I think I got mine like 6 months after it came out, so the Kinect, I didn't get a Kinect with mine.
Right, but so that's really appealing. That price is actually going to come in line a bit higher than what we use currently sell at, and we use a dead console. Like, so that's not bad. So summary, Nintendo is making a handheld that will dock into a station that will make it a regular console when you get home. It's going to be running performance that's somewhere in between Xbox One and a PS3, and it's going to be really, really cheap. The final thing that Nintendo's doing that is actually great, and they're learning from their mistakes, is the reason they kept on pushing this console back was because they wanted to have a lineup that was strong for launch. This console is rumored to be launching, we know, with a Zelda game for sure, and a Mario game, and a Pikmin, and, there was a few others, but not only do they have a bunch of games ready for launch, they have a bunch of games planned for every other month for the entire year of launch. Big names. So it's looking pretty solid for anyone that's a Nintendo fan. And as long as if enough Nintendo fans buy it, which I like, if everything pans out, they will for sure. Third parties will get on that.
Yeah, that was one other thing that was kind of weak with them. Nintendo wasn't third party.
That was a massive failure for them on the Wii U. To the point like that, third parties were announcing stuff at E3, like going, "It's going to be on the Wii U," and then years later, just going like, "Yeah, no."
That's not happening.
Which is like really sad. Do you guys think that the prices will rise again with the next-gen consoles? Or stay the same as they were this time around? Yeah, by next-gen, George, do you mean next half-gen or next full-gen? Because we're getting half-gen consoles.
I don't think they'd rise with half-gens, but I think with full-gens, they probably will rise, but I think they probably shouldn't.
I don't know.
They'll have to compete with more things, so they should probably not.
I will tell you right now, I promise you that the next PS4 and Xbox will cost £400 to £500.
They'll
cost the same amount as the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4 was under release.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they won't go any higher because like nobody will want it if they go higher.
Mm.
Like it's not it like it's a case of their the market
thing,
just
the
not
thing
being
is
made.
Even at those prices, I don't know if people are gonna want it. But we've talked about this a lot.
We talked a lot about the death of consoles.
There's definitely a threshold on like how high you can go, even with like a next gen console. Like,
yeah, for sure.
Because before you're just like the common working guy is not going to be able to get, and then you're losing just a massive part of your
argument.
Indulgence. Yes.
Against that, smartphones.
Smartphones.
They cost between £400 and £700 if you're talking about an iPhone or a Galaxy, and they ramp in sales. They sell more than consoles do.
I could see that, but
I feel like there's sources on the PlayStation's price that say that it will be the same as basically the PlayStation on launch. So we kind of know that. So we are saying the £450 mark for the new PlayStation. Xbox will follow suit because they have to, because that's how this market works, right?
Mm.
If those consoles sell well, the next ones after that will cost more. They are going to push it up. Every year they're going to push it up until they can't push it up more, because that's how this works. That's how the game of business works, you know? Like...
Mm-hmm.
They'll get you comfortable spending £400 on a games console every 3 years, and then they'll get you comfortable spending £500 on a console every 3 years, and it's like it's just gonna keep pushing it.
I don't see the point in spending that much on a console with how cheap PCs are becoming. I say that, but I've bought both an iPhone and an Xbox One.
George,
I'm right with you there,
George. But you're not, so for Sony that is a real argument, but for Microsoft's sneaky thing right now is they're trying to make the PC an Xbox, so they don't mind if you go buy a PC because they're going to be selling you Xbox games on the PC anyway.
Games, right?
So they're winning you away, and they're trying to slowly push the Windows Store. Like, all the Xbox games are going to be sold on the Windows Store, not on Steam, and they're trying to slowly kill Steam, right? So if Microsoft's plans pan out, you won't want or need an Xbox. You'll want a PC. It'll be cheaper than an Xbox, like, and it'll run better than an Xbox. But Microsoft's still winning, you know.
It's
the long game, but it is a really good strategy to beat Sony, because Sony can't do anything about it. They can't fight that fight. Right now. Like, consoles used to have the appeal of being much cheaper than PCs, which they're not anymore. And they used to have the appeal of just running, which is, like, slowly becoming an issue. Like, you've got games like Just Cause 3 that launched and was, like, running at, like, 15 FPS at times, and it's just like, what is this?
Is that unworkable at that point?
But it's still better than PC right now when it comes to the just running part. But it's getting worse the more they become PCs. And they are becoming PCs more every generation, you know? It's very weird. The market is in a very weird place right now. Like, the strangest it's been in a long time. We're gonna have to see how it pans out.
Mm-hmm.
Luke's seen a ghost.
I was just paying attention.
So,
focusing all of my efforts on this.
Is that us?
I think that's us. Oh my god.
I had plenty of people to play PC with, I would stop buying consoles altogether. The only reason I have consoles at the moment is to play with you guys and some friends from school now. Honestly, for sure.
Like, it does make a huge difference. I would have bought.
I'm lucky enough.
I have no preference.
Yeah.
For what console I was buying, and just everyone else I was getting Xboxes, so I was like, well, I guess I'm getting an Xbox.
Mm-hmm. I am lucky enough to be in a position where I can buy them all, and I have friends that want to play them all, so I get them all, but, like, if it wasn't for that, I would just be on PC. Like, I mean, that was my original plan, but then, like, I met you guys, and you ruined
Whoops.
It.
That's what we do.
Yeah. I mean, I built my PC as a console replacement, and I was going to just stay on it, and then I got an Xbox because of y'all. So, that was nice.
As it stands, I don't play PC games with anyone. I only play solo on PC games.
Yeah, that's also my thing. If a game comes out that's single player, I buy it on PC. If it comes out that's multiplayer and these guys are getting it, I buy it on Xbox. Like, my Xbox is a multiplayer machine, and my PC is a single player machine.
Uh-huh.
Makes sense. That'll work out well. The new show that we're doing.
Yay! Because I don't have an Elgato, because I'm a cheapskate.
Buy one.
I'm going to look into getting
I will, but I just bought a real fancy graphics card, so all of you guys can see the PC games I play on the streams in real fancy graphics.
Also, there have been two new rules added to the drinking game.
What's this?
Yeah,
for every new topic, doesn't include when they go off-topic official news. Drink whenever Andy is clearly messaging someone, probably Anne, on Skype.
I'm using that insider information.
She caught me in a fucking trap there, because she messaged me about the rule about the messaging and asked me what I thought. I was like, I can't win here, can I?
Anne has left now. That's alright.
No, she's already passed out from the drinking. She's an alcoholic.
Pokemon hunting. Wow.
Okay, sure.
She into that.
I kind of want to go and take the gym up the road.
Yeah, I think we're done.
We're finished.
Yeah. we need to finish so Luke can go and hunt Pokemon.
Yeah.
I need to pee more than anything else.
Someone shout us out.
Oh, okay, so thanks for sticking with us, guys. If you enjoyed, feel free to drop us a follow and follow us on YouTube. We always post all our podcasts on there. You can catch up on anything you want to miss, or if you want to go through our archive and have a look at our other stuff, you can go through there.
Mm-hmm.
Feel free to give us a follow on Twitter as well. We'll always be tweeting whenever we're doing anything new. So, like, with all these new things Kamal's going to be doing, we'll send out a tweet before that happens.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, if you ever want to send us any news that we're doing that you want us to cover, we'll cover that and we'll give you a shout out for whatever news.
George is following. I didn't know you weren't following, George. Thank you for following.
Oh, I didn't know you would.
God damn it.
It does mean you have to drink. That's how that works, George. You got to drink now.
Hey, the message, Anne. Don't let her get away with it.
Yeah. But yeah, as we said, we're going to be start doing some new stuff with Kamal, possibly me. But if you just keep following our Twitter, we'll keep you updated and all of that.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much us, right?
Yes. Bye, everyone.
I can help it if I make a scene.
Bye.
My heart pink limousine.